लीनियर ऑलजेब्रा एंड कैलकुलस मॉड्यूल 4 पार्ट 2.2 एब्सोल्यूट एंड कंडीशनल कन्वर्जेंस। फर्स्ट वी कैन सी व्हाट इज एन एब्सोल्यूट कन्वर्जेंस। ए सीरीज सिग्मा के इक्वल टू 1 टू इन्फिनिटी यू के इक्वल टू यू 1 प्लस यू 2 प्लस एक्सेट्रा प्लस यू के प्लस एक्सेट्रा इज सेट टू कन्वर्ज एब्सोल्यूटली if the series of absolute values namely sigma k equal to 1 to infinity modulus uk equal to modulus of u1 plus modulus of u2 plus etc plus modulus of uk plus etc converges and is said to diverge absolutely if the series of absolute values diverges. We can go through some examples where we will apply the concept. First one is determine whether the following series converge absolutely. There are two subdivisions for this problem. The first subdivision is 1 minus 1 by 2 minus 1 by 2 square plus 1 by 2 cube plus 1 by 2 raised to 4 minus 1 by 2 raised to 5 minus etc. Now what we will do is that here we will take the absolute values of the given series. And as you can see, the series of absolute values is actually 1 plus 1 by 2 plus 1 by 2 square plus 1 by 2 cube plus etc. which is actually a geometric series with A, namely the first term equal to 1 and 1 by 2 as the common ratio which is denoted as R. So based on that, we can on applying the series test that we have studied before regarding the convergence of a geometric series, we can conclude that the given series converges absolutely. Now the second subdivision, namely subdivision B, in the case of that subdivision, the series is 1 minus 1 by 2 plus 1 by 3 minus 1 by 4 plus 1 by 5 minus etc. Here, taking the absolute values of the series, we are getting 1 plus 1 by 2 plus 1 by 3 plus 1 by 4 plus 1 by 5 plus etc., which is actually the harmonic series, and we have already seen that it is a divergent series. So we can say, since the absolute values of the given series diverges, we can conclude that the given series diverges absolutely. Now the next is a theorem whose statement is, if the series sigma k equal to 1 to infinity modulus of uk equal to modulus of u1 plus modulus of u2 plus etc plus modulus of uk plus etc converges, then so does the series sigma k equal to 1 to infinity uk equal to u1 plus u2 plus etc plus uk plus etc. So based on this theorem, we can now move to the next theorem, which is called as the ratio test for absolute convergence. We are using this ratio test for absolute convergence in many of the problems where we are asked to check whether the given series is converges, whether it is converging or absolutely convergent. Okay, so the statement is, let sigma uk be a series with non-zero terms and suppose that rho equal to limit k tends to infinity modulus of uk plus 1 by modulus of uk. If rho less than 1, so this is a formula based on which we are calculating the rho, and depending upon the value of the rho, we will make the conclusions. So if you are getting the rho value less than 1, then the series sigma uk converges absolutely, and therefore it will converge according to the theorem that we have discussed just before. Now if you are getting this rho value greater than 1 or if rho equal to infinity, then the series sigma uk diverges. Suppose we are getting rho equal to 1, then no conclusion about the convergence or absolute convergence can be drawn from this test. Now let's see how we can apply the theorem that we have already discussed in the problems. The question is, use the ratio test for absolute convergence to determine whether the series converges. And there are two sub-problems given here as two subdivisions. The first subdivision is sigma k equal to 1 to infinity minus 1 raised to k, 2 raised to k by k factorial. And the second is a subdivision b, sigma k equal to 1 to infinity minus 1 raised to k, 2k minus 1 the whole factorial by 3 raised to k. So now we can solve the problem for the first subdivision. In the case of the first subdivision, what we will do is that we will take the absolute value of the general term uk here. So in this term here, uk is actually minus 1 raised to k, 2 raised to k by k factorial. Then taking the absolute value, it become modulus of uk equal to modulus of minus 1 raised to k, 2 raised to k by k factorial, which is equal to 2 raised to k by k factorial. Then we are going to apply the ratio test for absolute convergence here. So in that test, we have to find out rho. And we have just discussed about the formula for getting rho, and it is rho is equal to limit k tends to infinity modulus of uk plus 1 by mod uk, which is equal to limit k tends to infinity 2 raised to k plus 1 by k plus 1 factorial into k factorial by 2 raised to k. Now, k plus 1 factorial can be written as k plus 1 into k factorial. So, the k factorial in the denominator will get cancelled with the k factorial in the numerator. Also, the 2 raised to k plus 1 in the numerator can be also written as 2 raised to k into 2, and in which the 2 raised to k in the numerator will get cancelled with the 2 raised to k in the denominator. So, the simplified form of that term will be 2 by k plus 1. So, taking the limit k tends to infinity 2 by k plus 1, we are actually getting it as 2 by infinity, which is equal to 0, and that value of rho is actually less than 1, which implies that according to the ratio test that we have discussed, we can make the conclusion that since rho is less than 1, the series converges absolutely, and based on the theorem that we have discussed before, we can say hence the given series converges. Now moving to the second subdivision, where the series given is sigma k equal to 1 to infinity minus 1 raised to k, 2k minus 1 factorial by 3 raised to k. So here the general term uk is actually minus 1 raised to k, 2k minus 1 factorial by 3 raised to k. Now taking the absolute value of the general term uk, we will obtain modulus of uk equal to 2k minus 1 factorial by 3 raised to k. So we have to use the ratio test for absolute convergence, where we have to calculate rho, and you know the formula of rho is rho equal to limit k tends to infinity modulus of uk plus 1 by uk. Here we will substitute uk plus 1 as well as uk. So it will become equal to limit k tends to infinity minus 1 raised to k, 2 k plus 2 minus 1 the whole factorial by 3 raised to k plus 1 into 3 raised to k by 2k minus 1 factorial. So on simplifying that term, that means in the numerator it is actually given as 2k plus on expanding the on opening the bracket of the term inside in the numerator, you are getting it as 2k plus 2 minus 1 factorial, which is actually 2k plus 1 factorial. So in the next step, we have written that term as 2k plus 1 factorial. And if you are observing the term there, there is 3 raised to k in the numerator, and in the denominator there is 3 raised to k plus 1. We can split that 3 raised to k plus 1 as 3 raised to k into 3. So that 3 raised to k will get cancelled with the 3 raised to k in the numerator. So there will be only a 3 in the numerator, in the denominator from that cancellation. So it will, the term in turn will get simplified as limit k tends to infinity 1 by 3 into 2k plus 1 factorial by 2k minus 1 factorial. And you can write this 2k plus 1 factorial as 2k plus 1 into 2k into 2k minus 1 factorial. And from that, that 2k minus 1, the 2k minus 1 factorial will get cancelled with the 2k minus 1 factorial in the denominator. So after that cancellation, the term left in the numerator will be 2k into 2k plus 1. So since 1 by 3 is a constant, we can write that outside the limit. So it will become equal to 1 by 3 limit k tends to infinity 2k into 2k plus 1. And applying the limit, you are getting the value equal to infinity. That means you got rho equal to infinity. Then from the statement of the ratio test for absolute convergence, we can conclude that the series diverges. So that's all from this topic. From this topic of absolute convergence, next is actually conditional convergence. A series is said to be conditional convergent if it converges, but it does not converge absolutely. An example is the alternating harmonic series given by 1 minus 1 by 2 plus 1 by 3 minus 1 by 4 plus etc. plus minus 1 raised to k plus 1 into 1 by k plus etc. This series converges by Leibniz test but not absolutely convergent. So this is a conditionally convergent series. That's all from this part. Thank you.